Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2020 CJ Willing Trophy Cup. We're here to honour the first and best player of the 2020 FAFL season. What is the criteria for fairest and best, you may ask? To determine the best player, the three field umpires can confer after each home and away match and award 3 votes, 2 votes, and 1 vote to the players they regard as best, second best, and third best in the match, respectively. The fairest component of the award is achieved by making ineligible any player who was suspended by the FAFL Tribunal during the home and away season. An ineligible player cannot win, place, or be classified in the final Willing Trophy rankings, regardless of the number of votes they have received during the season. To protect the integrity of the Willing Trophy count, after each match is played and the votes have been cast and sealed in an envelope named Willing Trophy, the votes were transported to an Armadillo Guard vault in Melbourne. Before the count tonight, Armadillo Guard supervised the removal of votes to make sure the votes were intact as they were removed from the vault and delivered to the Pride Palladium in Melbourne, where the count is being held tonight. However, not everyone is here tonight. The Brisbane Brumbies and the Fremantle Panthers are back home before they fly into Melbourne later in the week. Brisbane are joining us en masse at the Brisbane Convention and Exhibition Centre in South Brisbane, and Fremantle are joining us en masse at the Pride Perth Resort and Casino in Burswood. Both of them are joining us for the count via satellite. And now on to round one. And here were the results from round one. Melbourne defeated Fremantle in the grand final rematch in Perth by 21 points. Melbourne City won their first game in the FAFL against the other newbies of 2020 in the Perth Ospreys by 44 points. Gold Coast gave Brisbane a hiding by 50 points in the season's first Queensland derby. East Sydney tried to avenge their finals loss in 2019 against Orange, but failed as the Myers pipped the Roosters again, this time by 8 points. Geelong had a close shave against Hobart, but managed to beat the Wolves on their home turf by 10 points. And finally, Darwin made easy work of Adelaide at Morara by 86 points, putting Darwin on top of the ladder at the end of round one. Round one, Fremantle versus Melbourne. Fremantle, C. Carpenter, 1 vote. Melbourne, J. Beattie, 2 votes. Melbourne, C. Warren, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Perth. Perth, R. Boss, 1 vote. Melbourne City, M. Harmon, 2 votes. Perth, P. Bate, 3 votes. Geelong versus Gold Coast versus Brisbane. Gold Coast, B. Murphy, 1 vote. Brisbane, L. Smith, 2 votes. Gold Coast, K. Slater, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Orange. East Sydney, D. Bristol, 1 vote. Orange, S. Lambert, 2 votes. Orange, R. Walker, 3 votes. That was a bit of a sign there. Hobart versus Geelong. Hobart, C. Long, 1 vote. Geelong, M. Knight, 2 votes. Hobart, A. Kahoa, 3 votes. Darwin versus Adelaide. Darwin, K. Shadowwolf, 1 vote. Darwin, A. Adler, 2 votes. Darwin, S. Corbett, A. 3 votes. Now onto the round two results. Melbourne continued with their winning ways by putting East Sydney in a rut, with the Hammerheads winning by 59 points. Fremantle bounced back with a win on the road against Orange in close fashion by 14 points. Adelaide's losing streak that had started in 2019 continued as the team struggled against Hobart at the Adelaide Oval, losing by 62 points. Perth continued to go along the tough row of the FAFL as they were beaten again, this time by Geelong, by 60 points. Gold Coast were given a challenge by Melbourne City, but were able to get across the line by 23 points. And in the final game of the round, Brisbane and Darwin played in a close one, with the Brisbane Brumbies getting the 4 points by 14 points. Round two, Melbourne versus East Sydney. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 1 vote. East Sydney, D. Gertner, 2 votes. Melbourne, E. Lancaster, three votes. Orange versus Fremantle. Orange, B. Johnson, one vote. Fremantle, R. McManus, two votes. Fremantle, C. Travston, three votes. Adelaide versus Hobart. Hobart, D. Quinn, one vote. Adelaide, J. Reid, two votes. Hobart, W. Haywood, three votes. Perth versus Geelong. Geelong, M. Knight, one vote. Geelong, R. Nimbus, two votes. Geelong, B. Warrior, three votes. Gold Coast versus Melbourne City. Melbourne City, R. Marsden, one vote. Gold Coast, K. Slater, two votes. Melbourne City, J. Trigg, three votes. Brisbane versus Darwin. Darwin, N. Baker, one vote. Brisbane, L. O'Dale, two votes. Darwin, S. Corbinet, three votes. Now to the results for round three. Melbourne played a close game against Orange, but managed to edge them out by 1 point in one of the games of the season. East Sydney's bad start continued as Fremantle got their second win of the season by defeating the Roosters by 29. Brisbane would make easy work of the struggling Adelaide side by 61 points as Adelaide still tried to get a win on the board. Gold Coast defeated Darwin by 45 points in an easy affair for the Dragons. Melbourne City won their first road game against Geelong. While it wasn't a long trip, they made the most of it by beating the Generals by 31. And finally, Perth made it hard for Hobart, but in the end, fell short by 19 points. Round 3, Orange versus Melbourne. Melbourne, E. Lancaster, 1 vote. Melbourne, J. Parker, 2 votes. Orange, R. Walker, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Fremantle. East Sydney, D. Gertner, 1 vote. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 2 votes. Fremantle, C. Travston, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Adelaide. Brisbane, J. Jones, 1 vote. Brisbane, Biakko, 2 votes. Brisbane, L. Smith, 3 votes. Darwin versus Gold Coast. Gold Coast, M. Jacatine, 1 vote. Darwin, N. Baker, 2 votes. Gold Coast, R. Tiggy, 3 votes. Geelong versus Melbourne City. Melbourne City, S. Westwood, 1 vote. Melbourne City, G. Crimmins, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Orlin, 3 votes. Perth versus Hobart. Perth, R. Boss, 1 vote. Perth, L. Millwood, 2 votes. Hobart, I. Sims, 3 votes. And on to the round 4 results here. Gold Coast and East Sydney played a classic on Thursday night football, but yet again the Roosters fell short in a close one. This time by 10 points. Melbourne City put in a pitiful effort against Melbourne in the first Melbourne derby. The Melbourne Hammerheads got the 4 points, while the Mariners only scored 24 points. The lowest score kicked by a team this season. Darwin won against Geelong in convincing fashion by 56 points, setting up the potential for Darwin to have a great year for the first time in franchise history. Hobart pulled off an upset when it defeated Fremantle by 17 points. Jay Samuelson clawed Adelaide back into their game against Orange, but it was too little too late as the Miners won by 21. And Brisbane gave Perth a hiding they won't forget as the Brumbies won by 110 points. Round 4, Gold Coast versus East Sydney. Gold Coast, O. Whitehurst, 1 vote. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 2 votes. East Sydney, F. Appleby, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Melbourne City. Melbourne, C. Warren, 1 vote. Melbourne City, L. Wilson, 2 votes. Melbourne, A. Condy, 3 votes. Darwin versus Geelong. Darwin, K. Shadowwolf, 1 vote. Darwin, K. Murphy, 2 votes. Darwin, D. Ray, 3 votes. Hobart versus Fremantle. Hobart, C. Long, 1 vote. Fremantle, M. Pedroza, 2 votes. Hobart, D. James, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Orange. Orange, B. Irving, 1 vote. Orange, Rudy Walker, 2 votes. Adelaide, Jay Samuelson, 3 votes. Perth versus Brisbane. Brisbane, G. Austin, 1 vote. Brisbane, V. Wilson, 2 votes. Brisbane, Al Smith, 3 votes. And on to the round 5 results. Gold Coast were convincingly beat Hobart by 31 points in front of the Thursday Night Lights of Carrara. Perth would get their first ever win in a scrappy affair against Adelaide that saw Perth win by 40 points. The match would be an outlier as this would be Perth's only win of the season. Orange and Darwin would play a high-scoring affair at Bloomfield, with the Miners winning by 22. Geelong grinded Melbourne to a halt to take home a win against Melbourne by 9. Fremantle made easy work of Brisbane by 63 points on Sunday afternoon in Perth. And Melbourne City had a resounding win against East Sydney by 17 points. The Roosters having a horrible start going 0-5. Round 5. Gold Coast versus Hobart. Gold Coast, M. Blake, 1 vote. Gold Coast, B. Thornton, 2 votes. Hobart, C. Hunter, 3 votes. Perth versus Adelaide. Perth, P. Bate, 1 vote. Adelaide, H. Carlson, 2 votes. Perth, Al Millwood, 3 votes. Orange versus Darwin. Orange, S. Lambert, 1 vote. Orange, Al King, 2 votes. Darwin, K. Shadowworth, 3 votes. Geelong versus Melbourne. Geelong, B. Warrior, 1 vote. Geelong, S. Star, A. Stark, 2 votes. Melbourne, S. Sergeant, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Brisbane. Brisbane, T. Bryson, 1 vote. Brisbane, L. Smith, 2 votes. Fremantle, J. Jansen, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus East Sydney. Melbourne City, M. Harmon, 1 vote. East Sydney, D. Gertner, 2 votes. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 3 votes. And the standings after round 5 are a bit of a surprise, as the player with the highest amount of votes at the moment is ineligible. Lido Smith with 10. Meaning that at the moment we've got in tied first, Rudy Walker of Orange looking for his 3rd medal, and Faith St. Clair of East Sydney looking for a 1st, both tied on 8 points. Meanwhile, it's pretty much tied across the board. In tied 3rd, we have the top 2 from the Michael Bendy Bruce medal in count, Michael Bendy Bruce this year, Michael Bendy Bruce medal goal count this year in Sky Corbett Day and Colin Travson, both with 6 votes. That we've got a huge load of players tied in 5th at the moment. Catherine Slater, Lula Millwood, Kyle Shadworth, and Darren Gertner all on 5. And then in ninth place, we've got Emily Lancaster, Caesar Warren, Paul Baton, Beatrice Warrior, all with 4 votes. So this looks like it's going to be an interesting count here. I mean, you've got Walker and St. Clair 2 votes behind Smith, and Smith currently having the most votes but being ineligible. What a feeling it would be for him if he ended up polling the most amount of votes tonight, and he would be ineligible to win the award. So, moving on to round 6. East Sydney would finally snap their losing streak in huge fashion by dropping the Perth Ospreys by 107 points. Darwin would shock the world by defeating the reigning premiers in valiant fashion by 11 points. Melbourne City made easy work of Adelaide to win by 62 points at Docklands. Orange's inaccurate kicking would come back to hurt them in their clash against Geelong, as the Generals would get across the line with better kicking by 30 points. The trend of Melbourne winning at the MCG against the Gold Coast, but the Gold Coast winning against Melbourne at Carrara continued, as the Hammerheads won on home turf by 17 points. And Brisbane would have another big win, this time against Hobart, by 78 points. Round 6, East Sydney versus Perth. East Sydney, D. Golin, 1 vote. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 2 votes. E. Sydney, J. Phillips, 3 votes. Darwin versus Fremantle. Darwin, S. Josephs, 1 vote. Darwin, H. Connor, 2 votes. Fremantle, R. McManus, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Adelaide. Adelaide, W. Kellogg, 1 vote. Adelaide, Cotsey, 2 votes. Melbourne City, Mitchell Harmon, 3 votes. Geelong versus Orange. Orange, Rudy Walker, 1 vote. Geelong, B. Warrior, 2 votes. Geelong, A. Stark, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Gold Coast. Gold Coast, M. Jacatine, 1 vote. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 2 votes. Melbourne, A. Wade, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Hobart. Brisbane, J. Hurst, 1 vote. Hobart, A. Backus, 2 votes. Brisbane, Bianco, 3 votes. Now on to round 7. Fremantle would win the first showdown between the WA teams as they wiped the floor with Perth by 132 points. Melbourne City would pull off a win at the Gabba against Brisbane in a good contest that saw Melbourne City win by 14. The Anzac Day clash between Melbourne and Adelaide would be a fizzer as the Hammerheads made easy work of Adelaide, winning by 111 points. Adelaide's losing streak since round 1 2019 would continue. Orange would have made an inspiring Orange would have an inspiring performance against the Gold Coast in Wellington as the Myers would come back to win by 22 points. Geelong would finally get their first win in an international game as they defeated East Sydney by 79 points. And finally, Hobart and Don would play a belter that saw the Hobart Wolves win by 9 points. Round 7. Fremantle versus Perth. Perth, T. Howe, 1 vote. Fremantle, C. Baxter, 2 votes. Fremantle, C. Travson, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Melbourne City. Melbourne City, L. Wilson, 1 vote. Melbourne City, J. Trigg, 2 votes. Melbourne City, D. Harmon, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Adelaide. Adelaide, K. Rogers, 1 vote. Melbourne, J. Beatty, 2 votes. Melbourne, A. Condy, 3 votes. Orange versus Gold Coast. Orange, A. May, 1 vote. Gold Coast, E. Anderson, 2 votes. Gold Coast, T. Rogers, 3 votes. Geelong versus East Sydney. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 1 vote. Geelong, J. Orlan, 2 votes. Geelong, O. Paris, 3 votes. Hobart versus Darwin. Hobart, D. Quinn, 1 vote. Darwin, S. Corbidae, 2 votes. Hobart, J. Jinks, 3 votes. And on to the round 8 results. Melbourne City would make easy work of Darwin as the Mariners would continue their good start in the FAFL as they defeated the Storm by 40 points. Fremantle would give Geelong a reality check as the 2019 Premiers defeated the Generals by 58 points. Perth would be battered again, this time against the Gold Coast, who would drive them into the ground by 149 points. Melbourne and Hobart played another close one at Belrive Oval, but Melbourne would get home by 20 points. Brisbane would have a huge surprise this round as they defeated Orange by a huge margin of 104 points. Meanwhile, Adelaide would play a close one with East Sydney, but the Roosters would deny Adelaide one of their first win of the season by 32 points. Round 8. Melbourne versus Darwin. Or Melbourne City versus Darwin, sorry. Melbourne City, G. Crimmins, 1 vote. Melbourne City, Callum Murray, 2 votes. Darwin, H. Connor, 3 votes. Geelong versus Fremantle. Geelong, L. Adamley, one vote. Fremantle, C. Travson, two votes. Fremantle, J. Rosewood, three votes. Gold Coast versus Perth. Gold Coast, M. Blake, one vote. Gold Coast, R. Tiggy, two votes. Gold Coast, B. Murphy, three votes. Hobart versus Melbourne. Hobart, C. Meadows, one vote. Hobart, J. Barrett, to two votes. Melbourne, J. Hawkins Jr., three votes. Brisbane versus Orange. Brisbane, J. Hurst, one vote. Orange, S. Lambert, two votes. Brisbane, L. Smith, three votes. Adelaide versus East Sydney. Adelaide, H. Carlson, one vote. Adelaide, J. Minnelli, two votes. East Sydney, D. Bristol, three votes. And on to the round 9 results. Geelong would head to Adelaide and have a field day as they would defeat the Butcherbirds by 48 points. East Sydney and Darwin would play a classic in the nation's capital. Darwin would be in front by 1 point as the final siren sounded and would take on the 4 points from Canberra. Hobart would prove that Melbourne City could be up and down in form as the Lonely Wolves defeated the Mariners by 21 points. Fremantle would make work, easy work of a disappointing Gold Coast side by 60 points. Brisbane would upset Melbourne at the MCG by 6 points. Melbourne's starting to look like they had some chinks in the armour after the 2019 Grand Final loss. And Orange would continue Perth's lack of form as they defeated the Ospreys by 95 points. Round 9. Adelaide versus Geelong. Adelaide, J. McGrew, 1 vote. Geelong, R. Nimbus, 2 votes. Geelong, J. Orland, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Darwin. Darwin, H. Connor, 1 vote. East Sydney, N. Acker, 2 votes. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Hobart. Melbourne City, G. That meant. God, they've written the wrong name down. I'm going to take... Okay. Okay, they actually have the right name. Sorry. This is not going well. Melbourne City, G. Milford, one vote. Melbourne City, D. Harmon, two votes. Hobart, D. Quinn, three votes. God. Fremantle versus Gold Coast. Okay, Fremantle, C. Travston, one vote. Fremantle, T. Ironmonger, two votes. Fremantle, R. McManus, three votes. Sorry about that one before. The names were right. I forgot Gideon Milford was picked up by Melbourne City. Melbourne versus Brisbane. Brisbane, R. Salvatore, one vote. Brisbane, M. Gutch, two votes. Melbourne, A. Condi, three votes. Orange versus Perth. Orange, C. Brooks, one vote. Orange, E. Sims, two votes. Orange, R. Walker, three votes. Jeez, and after that bit of a blunder of a round, let's get on with the round 10 results. Hobart made it hard for Orange when they came into town to take on the Wolves. Hobart getting the chocolates by 45 points. East Sydney would give Melbourne a 1-2 punch as they would give them a shock defeat for the second week in a row by 24 points. Brisbane would defeat the travelling Geelong by 25 points at the Gabba. Adelaide would play their best game in 2020 yet, but would be beaten by the Gold Coast by only 13 points. Fremantle would make easy work of Melbourne at their traditional home ground by 91 points. Finally, Perth's form would not get any better as yet again they were blown out of order, this time by Darwin and by 91 points. Round 10, Hobart versus Orange. Hobart, L. Hardy, one vote. Orange, R. Whitfield, two votes. Hobart, T-Shady, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Melbourne. Melbourne, JBD, 1 vote. Melbourne, A. Connie, 2 votes. East Sydney, Al Dealan, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Geelong. Geelong, A. Edison, 1 vote. Brisbane, Bianco, 2 votes. Brisbane, Al Smith, 3 votes. Gold Coast versus Adelaide. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 1 vote. Adelaide, Coetzee, 2 votes. Gold Coast, B. Murphy, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Melbourne City. Fremantle, C. Travston, 1 vote. Fremantle, R. McManus, 2 votes. Fremantle, C. Moody, 3 votes. Wait, what the... So we duplicated that one twice. Okay. Darwin versus Park. Darwin, K. Murphy, 1 vote. Darwin, K. Shower, 2 votes. Darwin, S. Covade, 3 votes. And onto the round 11 results. I hope this doesn't get more and more sloppy. That's just all I'll say. Darwin will continue to keep the momentum going and defeat Hobart by 27 points at Morara Oval. Path came close to being Melbourne, but they just couldn't get it done as the Hammerheads came home to win by 28 points. Geelong would defeat the Gold Coast, who struggled to kick straight, by 33 points. Melbourne City would struggle against Orange, as the Myers would make easy work of City, as Orange won by 56 points. East Sydney would get another win as they would knock off Brisbane by 47 points. And Adelaide would keep up with Fremantle for most of their clash, but after a disastrous final quarter, Fremantle would win by the decent margin of 50 points. Round 11, Darwin vs. Hobart. Hobart, D. James, 1 vote. Hobart, D. Quinn, 2 votes. Darwin, A. Adler, 3 votes. Perth vs. Melbourne. Perth, A. Bucket, 1 vote. Melbourne, C. Warren, 2 votes. Perth, P. Bate, 3 votes. Geelong vs. Gold Coast. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 1 vote. Geelong, A. Stark, 2 votes. Geelong, M. Knight, 3 votes. Orange vs. Melbourne City. Orange, S. Lambert, 1 vote. Melbourne City, S. Westwood, 2 votes. Orange, R. Walker, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Brisbane. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 1 vote. East Sydney, D. Gertner, 2 votes. East Sydney, Derek Bristol, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Fremantle. Adelaide, M. Fox, 1 vote. Fremantle, J. James, 2 votes. Adelaide, J. Samuelson, 3 votes. And looking at the standings after round 11, and Lido Smith has still polled the most amount of votes, and it is still tied in first, Rudy Walker and Faith St. Clair on 15. With Colin Trampson in third with 13, Corvidae and Angela Condi tied in 4th with 11, McManus in 6th with 10, and 7th is James Orton of Geelong with 8. If I'm Lido Smith, I'm probably starting to feel a bit off here, because there is a huge potential that this guy could have polled the most amount of votes by the time we get to the end of round 22. And thanks to an incident back in round 13, he will not be eligible to claim the award. So it is currently Rudy Walker and Faith St. Clair leading the count by 15 votes. With 15 votes. So. And before we continue, as we're at the halfway point, let's have a look at the other major award winners this year. Winner of the Michael Bendy Bruce Medal for leading goal kicker was Colin Travesner of Fremantle. First time for him, and he will have a chance to win his second Premiership medallion this Saturday afternoon in the 2020 FFL Grand Final. Meanwhile, on to the Jimmy Noon medalist for Best Rookie. Ashlyn Adler became the second Darwin player in a row to win it, and she is a very deserving winner of it. We do hope that she continues to play great football. On to the Anzac Day medal. As we said earlier, it was a bit of a blowout, so it was to be expected it would be a Melbourne player, and that player was Angela Condy. And while it was a bit of a forgettable year for the Hammerheads, they did at least win the Anzac Day game pretty convincingly. On to the Teddy Wilson medal for best on ground during the All-Star game, we have our two-time reigning CJ Willing Trophy winner Rocco McManus won that medal at the end of a tied All-Star game. It was a very good game from start to finish. And on to the 2020 FFL Grand Finalist, it's the Brisbane Brumbies, only their third year as a team, taking on the Fremantle Panthers, who have been in the last two Grand Finals, at making their third straight trip to the Grand Final. They are trying to go back-to-back, Brisbane trying to win their first ever Premiership. And we cannot forget the 2021 FAFL expansion teams who will be coming in next season. It is, of course, the Cairns Corals and the Wellington Vipers. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome them to the league. And on to the round 12 results as we continue the count. Darwin would make their presence known to the rest of the league as they would knock off the Melbourne Hammerheads at the MCG by 5 points. Orange would avoid a repeat of what happened when they lost Met Adelaide and made sure to keep it in control for the entire game. Orange won by 50 points. Geelong would defeat Perth in a close game by the Osprey standards. The final margin was 25 points. Gold Coast would head to Melbourne and get their first win in Melbourne since the 2018 Grand Final when they made easy work of the Melbourne City Mariners by 80 points. East Sydney would head to Hobart and live to tell the tale, as the Roosters would defeat the Wolves by 26 points. And Fremantle would head to the Gabba to take on Brisbane. The reigning premiers would get the win by 33 points. Round 12, Melbourne versus Darwin. Melbourne, S. Sargent, 1 vote. Darwin, S. Josephs, 2 votes. Darwin, K. Murphy, 3 votes. Is that slow? Orange versus Adelaide. Adelaide, Kotze, 1 vote. Orange, C. Brooks, 2 votes. Adelaide, J. McGrew, 3 votes. Geelong versus Perth. Geelong, L. Hollis, 1 vote. Geelong, D. Whitler, 2 votes. Perth, S. Matthews, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Gold Coast. Gold Coast, Brandon Murphy, 1 vote. Melbourne City, C. Murray, 2 votes. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 3 votes. Hobart versus East Sydney. Hobart, C. Long, 1 vote. East Sydney, L. Dillon, 2 votes. East Sydney, N. Grimmer, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Fremantle. Fremantle, C. Trampson, 1 vote. Fremantle, R. Champion, 2 votes. Fremantle, J. Gomez, 3 votes. And on to the round 13 results. And after 30 losses in a row, ranging back to round 1, 2019, Adelaide broke through for their first win since round 18, 2018, after defeating Perth by the huge margin of 87 points. Fremantle would take on East Sydney and defeat them by 33 points. Hobart would be unable to take advantage of Gold Coast's inaccurate kicking and were defeated by 36 points. The second Melbourne Derby would be a much better affair, but it would still be Melbourne defeating Melbourne City, this time by the much smaller margin of 7 points. Geelong would win in Orange by 17 points in a close game against the Miners, and Brisbane would get it done in the Darwin Sun against the Storm by 26 points. Round 13, Adelaide versus Perth. Adelaide, B. Martin, 1 vote. Adelaide, T. Mitchelson, 2 votes. Adelaide, D. Goline, 3 votes. Fremantle versus East Sydney. Fremantle. Z. Roggles, 1 vote. Fremantle. J. Rosewood, 2 votes. East Sydney. N. Grimmer, 3 votes. Hobart versus Gold Coast. Gold Coast. B. Murphy, 1 vote. Hobart. M. Thornburn, 2 votes. Gold Coast. A. Warner, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Melbourne. Melbourne. T. Remington, 1 vote. Melbourne. J. Hawkins Jr., 2 votes. Melbourne. A. Condi, 3 votes. And on to Orange versus Geelong. Orange, Al Gore, 1 vote. Orange, R. Walker, 2 votes. Gold Coast, G. Perkins, 3 votes. Darwin versus Brisbane. Darwin, D. Cole, 1 vote. Brisbane, J. Hurst, 2 votes. Brisbane, L. Smith, 3 votes. And on to the round 14 results. Melbourne City would put together another good effort as they would defeat Hobart by 10 points at Bellarive Oval. Adelaide couldn't go back-to-back on the trot as Darwin brought them back to reality by 30 points. Things continued to get worse for Perth as Orange would embarrass them on home turf by 107 points. Fremantle would get revenge against Melbourne for winning against them in round 1 and would be able to repeat what they did in the grand final and defeat Melbourne at the MCG. The final margin was 28 points. East Sydney would give Geelong a loss they wouldn't forget as the Roosters would make easy work of Geelong by 49 points. And in the last game of the round, Brisbane for the first time would get bragging rights in Queensland as they would defeat an undercooked Gold Coast by 25 points. Round 14, Hobart versus Melbourne City. Hobart, C. Hunter, 1 vote. Melbourne City, S. Westwood, 2 votes. Melbourne City, M. Harmon, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Darwin. Adelaide, J. McGrew, 1 vote. Darwin, D. Kemp, 2 votes. Darwin, D. Cole, 3 votes. Perth versus Orange. Orange, S. Lambert, 1 vote. Orange, R. Selby, 2 votes. Orange, C. Brooks, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Fremantle. Fremantle, R. McManus, 1 vote. Melbourne, J. Gordon, 2 votes. Fremantle, M. Pedrosa, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Geelong. Geelong, A. Addison, 1 vote. East Sydney. F. St. Clair, 2 votes. East Sydney, T. Houston, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Gold Coast. Brisbane. R. Salvatore, 1 vote. Brisbane. J. Hurst, 2 votes. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 3 votes. And on to the round 15 results. Gold Coast and East Sydney would play the match of the round with the Gold Coast winning by 4 points. Fremantle and Orange would play in a close second with the Fremantle Panthers winning by 23 points. Melbourne would again thrash Adelaide as the Hammerheads had an easy trip to the Adelaide Oval, winning by 87 points. Melbourne City would win against Geelong under the dome of Docklands Stadium by 35 points. Hobart would defeat Brisbane and Launceston as the Wolves would win by 29 points. And Darwin would be the latest team to give Perth a hiding as the Storm would win by 131 points. Round 15, East Sydney versus Gold Coast. East Sydney. D. Gertner, 1 vote. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 2 votes. East Sydney. F. St. Clair, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Orange. Orange. S. Lambert, 1 vote. Fremantle, C. Trastan, 2 votes. Fremantle, R. McManus, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Melbourne. Adelaide, J. Samuelson, 1 vote. Melbourne, E. Lancaster, 2 votes. Melbourne, A. Condy, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Geelong. Geelong, G. Perkins, 1 vote. Geelong, B. Sanchez, 2 votes. Geelong, A. Edison, 3 votes. Hobart versus Brisbane. Brisbane, G. Abbey, 1 vote. Brisbane, J. Chadwick, 2 votes. Hobart, C. Hunter, 3 votes. Perth versus Darwin. Darwin, K. Shadwolf, 1 vote. Darwin, S. Josephs, 2 votes. Darwin, A. Adler, 3 votes. And on to the standings after round 15, and Faith St. Clair has cleared Lido Smith by 1 vote and is leading the count with 20 votes, and she, if she can keep it going from here, she will win not only because of Smith's ineligibility, well, she will win not because of Smith's ineligibility, but she will win it on pure merit here if she does win this, because she's on 20 votes right now. East Sydney didn't have a great season, but it seems like Faith St. Clair did. Behind her by 3 votes is Rudy Walker and Angela Conby breathing down her neck, and they certainly had good seasons. But we can't forget some of the people in the bubble, like Colin Trafton on 16. He had a great season. Austin Warner, some would say, was the best ruck fur of the season. And while he didn't get that spot on the Furry Australian team, he's perhaps showing those selectors maybe why he should have gotten that spot, as he's in fifth with 15 votes, and I'm pretty sure he has a bit of a fast finish there. Meanwhile, you can't count out Rocky McManus. He's sixth on 14 votes. He has a great finish too, and considering that the guy is the two-time reigning CJ Willing Trophy winner, you can't count out the guy who's done it twice before. And meanwhile, you got Sky Coverdale in 7th with 11 votes. He'd have to really get a lot of votes in the final rounds if he's to win this one. And you'd have to think that Murphy and Harmon at the bottom are kind of just making the numbers at this point. They are 11 votes behind Faith St. Clair. And while they had decent seasons, I don't think they're going to make it. But to be tied 8th is still a good thing in this. So at the moment, we've got Faith St. Clair on top with 20 votes. Then we have the ineligible Lido Smith with 19 votes. Then tied second, we have Rudy Walker and Angela Condy on 17 votes. Colin Trazen in fourth at 16. Austin Warren in fifth with 15. Rocky McManus in sixth with 14. In seventh, Sky Corday with 11. And then tied eighth, we've got Brendan Murphy and Mitchell Harmon on 9. So this is going to be a very, very good finish to this count. And If it goes the way we think it's going to go, this might be the best count we've had since 2015. This might go down to the final round. So let's continue and get on with round 16. Brisbane would bounce back and give East Sydney a beating by 59 points. Perth would continue their slides as the Gold Coast defeated them by 57 points at Perth Stadium. Adelaide would get close to their second win of the year, but Hobart, with an off of the siren goal, would get the win by 4 points. Geelong would get a win on the Hello Turf of the MCG against Melbourne by 14 points. Melbourne would be stuck in a slide that would see them fall down the ladder that would see them finish 7th on the ladder by the end of the year. Melbourne City would give Fremantle a shock as the Mariners would defeat the Panthers by 51 points. And finally, Darwin would defeat Orange on their way to a great finish to the season by 43 points. Round 16. Brisbane versus East Sydney. East Sydney, D. Gurner, 1 vote. East Sydney, F. St. Clair, 2 votes. Brisbane, L. Smith, 3 votes. Perth versus Gold Coast. Gold Coast, M. Blake, 1 vote. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 2 votes. Gold Coast, B. Murphy, 3 votes. Hobart versus Adelaide. Adelaide, Kutzy, 1 vote. Adelaide, D. Goline, 2 votes. Adelaide, J. Samuelson, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Geelong. Melbourne, E. Lancaster, 1 vote. Geelong, L. Adamley, 2 votes. Melbourne, J. Beattie, 3 votes. Mount C versus Fremantle. Fremantle, R. Champion, 1 vote. Fremantle, J. Jansen, 2 votes. Mountain City, J. Huxtable, 3 votes. Darwin versus Orange. Darwin, K. Shadowwolf, 1 vote. Orange, S. Lambert, 2 votes. Darwin, S. Corbidae, 3 votes. And on to the round 17 results. Orange would win the battle for New South Wales in an easy fashion by 72 points. Fremantle and Perth would play a close but scrappy affair. While Perth would get close, Fremantle would win by 6 points. Geelong and Darwin would play the match of the round, with Geelong getting across the line by 2 points. Adelaide would shock the Gold Coast as they would defeat the 2018 Premiers by 15 points to get their second win of the season. Melbourne would play another close game against Hobart and win at the MCG, with the Hammerheads winning by 20 points. And Melbourne City would put on a pathetic effort when they would only score 36 points against Brisbane. The Brumbies making easy work of them by 79 points. Round 17. Orange versus Easton. Orange. R. Walker, 1 vote. Orange, B. Johnson, 2 votes. Orange, K. Hurry, 3 votes. Perth versus Fremantle. Fremantle. M. Pedroza, 1 vote. Fremantle. R. McManus, 2 votes. Fremantle. Z. Roggles, 3 votes. Geelong versus Darwin. Darwin. A. Adler, 1 vote. Darwin. D. Cole, 2 votes. Darwin. K. Shadowworth, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Gold Coast. Adelaide, J. Reid, 1 vote. Adelaide, J. Samuelson, 2 votes. Adelaide, J. McGrew, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Hobart. Hobart, C. Hunter, 1 vote. Hobart, C. Meadows, 2 votes. Hobart, D. Quinn, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Brisbane. Brisbane. Al Fry, 1 vote. Brisbane. Jay Hurst, 2 votes. Brisbane. G. Abbey, 3 votes. Getting close to the end now. As we enter the round 18 results, Brisbane would win easily against Geelong at Cadinia Park by the margin of 53 points. Melbourne City would try to bounce back after their dreadful performance against Brisbane, but despite a better performance, they would still go down to the Force of Orange, this time by 51 points. East Sydney would show Adelaide that despite their improvements, there was still a lot of work to be done as they defeated the Butcher Birds by 55 points. Darwin would head to Carrara and become the first team to beat the Gold Coast at home in 2020 as they would get across the line by 3 points. Hobart would give a fright to Fremantle as they would knock off the 2019 Premiers by the small margin of 4 points. And finally, Melbourne would give Perth another licking in a series of lickings, this time by 83 points. Round 18, Geelong versus Brisbane. Brisbane. Arne Salvatore, 1 vote. Brisbane. M. Nugent, 2 votes. Brisbane. G. Abbey, 3 votes. Melbourne City versus Orange. Orange. B. Johnson, 1 vote. Orange. L. King, 2 votes. Orange. S. Lambert, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Adelaide. Adelaide, Cootsie, 1 vote. East Sydney. J. Phillips, 2 votes. East Sydney. D. Bristol, 3 votes. Gold Coast versus Darwin. Darwin. G. Rowland, 1 vote. Gold Coast. A. Warner, 2 votes. Darwin. A. Adler, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Hobart. Hobart. D. James, 1 vote. Fremantle. R. McManus, 2 votes. Hobart. D. Quinn, 3 votes. Melbourne versus Perth. Melbourne. J. Beattie, 1 vote. Melbourne. E. Lancaster, 2 votes. Perth. S. Matthews, 3 votes. And we are on to round 19 here. Only 4 rounds to go, and it still can pretty much be won by any of the front runners here. Darwin and Melbourne City played in the league's first draw since 2015 when both teams took each other at Morara Oval on Thursday night. Gold Coast would give Melbourne a night to forget as they defeated the Hammerheads by 38 points at Carrara. Brisbane would make Adelaide wish they were playing the Gold Coast as they would drill them into the ground by 98 points. Hobart would make the trip to Orange and would give them a defeat that would leave them in the bubble of missing out of the finals by 14 points. And both Perth Stadium games would be moved to Monday night and Tuesday night respectively as the turf of the ground had to be replaced as it was considered too dangerous. Both games would be forgettable, however, as East Sydney would make easy work of Perth, and despite getting Beaches Warrior back in record time from the FBA Combine, Geelong would put in a lousy effort against Fremantle. Round 19. Darwin versus Melbourne City. Darwin. N. Baker, 1 vote. Darwin. H. Connor, 2 votes. Darwin. A. Adler, 3 votes. Gold Coast versus Melbourne. Gold Coast. B. Murphy, 1 vote. Melbourne. D. Knightley, 2 votes. Gold Coast. A. Warner, 3 votes. Perth versus East Sydney. East Sydney. D. Bristol, 1 vote. East Sydney. F. St. Clair, 2 votes. Oh, got to repeat again. Okay. God, I really need to put this back. Right. Perth. R. Neighbor, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Brisbane. Brisbane. J. Hurst, 1 vote. Brisbane. V. Wilson, 2 votes. Brisbane. Bianco, 3 votes. Orange versus Hobart. Hobart. D. Ashcroft, 1 vote. Orange. Amy, 2 votes. Hobart, D. Quinn, 3 votes. And on to Fremantle versus Geelong. Geelong, A. G. Parkins, 1 vote. Geelong, A. Edison, 2 votes. Fremantle. R. McManus, 3 votes. And on to the round 20 results here. And let's just say it is getting very close between Faith St. Clair, Austin Warner, and Rocco McManus here. It looks like it's down to those three at the moment. It's pretty much going to be them fighting for it in the final 3 rounds here. So let's get on with round 20. Perth came very close to getting their second win of the year against Melbourne City, but the Mariners would keep it together and win by 4 points. East Sydney proved to be dominant again as they defeated Hobart by 99 points. Geelong bounced back from their bad performance against Fremantle to take an easy win against Adelaide by 59 points. Brisbane would defeat Melbourne, this time at the Gabba, by 40 points. Brisbane at this point had become a well-oiled team and were treading very closely to the minor premiership. Gold Coast brushed by with a close win against Orange by 9 points at Carrara, and Darwin defeated Fremantle again, this time in Perth, by 4 points. Round 20, Perth versus Melbourne City. Perth, D. Ray, 1 vote. Melbourne City, R. Marsden, 2 votes. Perth, S. Matthews, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Hobart. East Sydney, T. Houston, 1 vote. East Sydney, L. Dealen, 2 votes. East Sydney, D. Bristol, 3 votes. Geelong versus Adelaide. Geelong, J. Olin, 1 vote. Geelong, B. Warrior, 2 votes. Adelaide, J. Samuelson, 1 vote, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Melbourne. Melbourne, J. Horns Jr., 1 vote. Brisbane, J. Jones, 2 votes. Melbourne, J. Beattie, 3 votes. Gold Coast versus Orange. Orange, S. Lambert, 1 vote. Orange, E. Clayton, 2 votes. Gold Coast, A. Warner, 3 votes. Fremantle versus Darwin. Darwin, D. Kemp, 3 votes, 1 vote. Fremantle, J. Gomez, 2 votes. Darwin, K. Murphy, 3 votes. And now onto the standings after round 20, and after a brilliant second half of the season, Austin Warner is currently leading Faith St. Clair by a vote. With about 2 rounds to go, it is pretty much down to Rocco McManus, Faith St. Clair, and Austin Warner for the 2020 CJ Willing Trophy. And first, we've got Warner with 25, St. Clair in second with 24, Lido Smith ineligible with 22. Rocco McManus in third with 21. And pretty much everyone below that is out of the hunt. Which means Rudy Walker with 18 is out. Angela Condy with 17 is out. Colin Travis and Dale Quinn with 16 are out. Ashlyn Adler and Jay Samson with 15 are out. It is down to Austin Warner of the Gold Coast, Faith St. Clair of East Sydney, and Rocco McManus of Fremantle, gunning for his third in a row. This, my friends, is going to be a big final 2 rounds here, because these games are going to decide who wins this medal. I wish good luck to the 3 remaining players, and let's get on with round 21. Orange would pretty much end once and for all that the the perception that the MCG was a hard ground to win at when they defeated the Hammerheads by 14 points. Melbourne City's first trip to Adelaide since the 1970s would be a good one for them as they would defeat Adelaide by 86 points. Perth would be begging for the season to end once Brisbane beat them by 154 points. Their 12th spot on the ladder and the wooden spoon was finally theirs. Fremantle would become the second team to beat Gold Coast at Carrara in 2020 when they met on Saturday. The Panthers winning by 39 points. Darwin would end East Sydney's finals ambitions when they dragged them over the coals on Sunday. The Storm winning by 76 points. And finally, Geelong and Hobart would play in a high-scoring affair with the Wolves' finals hopes on the line. The Wolves would fall short by 15 points, as the Generals would set themselves up for a match against the Gold Coast for a top four spot in round 22. Round 21, Melbourne versus Orange. Melbourne, J. Beattie, 1 vote. Orange, S. Lambert, 2 votes. Orange, E. Clayton, 3 votes. Adelaide versus Melbourne City. Melbourne City, K. McCormick, 1 vote. Melbourne City, R. Marsden, 2 votes. Melbourne City, S. Westwood, 3 votes. Brisbane versus Perth. Brisbane. M. Nugent, 1 vote. Brisbane. J. Van Middlesworth, 2 votes. Brisbane. K. Ryan, 3 votes. Gold Coast versus Fremantle. Fremantle. R. Champion, 1 vote. Fremantle. Z. Everett, 2 votes. Fremantle. R. McManus, 3 votes. Darwin versus East Sydney. Darwin, S. Corvette, 1 vote. Darwin, A. Adler, 2 votes. East Sydney. F. St. Clair, 3 votes. Geelong versus Hobart. Wait, Geelong. There's no Geelong. Where's Geelong? Okay, Geelong versus Hobart. Geelong, G. Perkins, 1 vote. Geelong, D. Whitler, 2 votes. Hobart, A. Carr, 3 votes. And on to the round 22 results here. Yeah, sorry about that graphical thing where we didn't have the votes up for Geelong versus Hobart. I will repeat them, that it was Gregory Perkins, 1 vote, Damian Whitler, 2 votes, and Akome Kahoa, 3 votes. So, Perkins is on 6 votes at the moment, Whitler is on 4 votes at the moment, and Kahoa is on 6 votes at the moment. So, there is your reference there. So, with that blunder, that sets up a final round shootout between Faith St. Clair, Austin Warner, and Rocco McManus. For Warner, for Faith St. Clair to claim the prize, she just has to get a vote. For Austin Warner, he has to poll 2 votes or more and hope that St. Clair does not poll any votes to claim the award. And for McManus, he must hope that St. Clair does not poll any votes for the award, that Warner polls less than 2 votes for the award, and he must get 3 votes in this next game. So it is 27 for Faith St. Clair, 25 for Austin Warner, and 24 for Rocco McManus, as we look at the results for round 22. Hobart would end their season with a resounding win against Perth to go 11-11. The team might have missed the finals again, but the potential to make it back to the finals in 2021 is certainly there. In the battle for fourth position on the ladder, Gold Coast would defend their home turf and win by 23 points. Gold Coast would go to Brisbane to play in a qualifying final, while Geelong would have to head back home to host Orange in an elimination final. Brisbane would finish their season by defeating Orange by 48 points. This win was good enough for the Brumbies to claim the minor premiership. Melbourne City would claim a home final when they defeated East Sydney by 18 points. Adelaide would provide the upset of the season as the Butcherbirds would win for the third time this season and against the 2019 Premiers and the Fremantle Panthers at the Fremantle Oval. Adelaide had won by 15 points. And in the final game of the season, Darwin would claim a top four spot for their finals debut against Melbourne, who had become a far cry from their 2019 counterparts. Okay, round 22. Hobart versus Perth. Perth, S. Matthews, 1 vote. Perth, P. Bate, 2 votes. Hobart, J. Hale, 3 votes. Orange versus Brisbane. Brisbane, G. Abbey, 1 vote. Brisbane, V. Wilson, 2 votes. Brisbane, B. Ford, 3 votes. Darwin versus Melbourne. Darwin, S. Josephs, 1 vote. Melbourne, J. Hawkins Jr., 2 votes. Darwin, A. Adler, 3 votes. Gold Coast versus Geelong. Geelong, A. Edison, 1 vote. Gold Coast. M. Jacketing, 2 votes. Geelong, A. Stark, 3 votes. East Sydney versus Melbourne City. Melbourne City, S. Cole, 1 vote. Melbourne City, W. Hine, 2 votes. Melbourne City, G. Milford, 3 votes. So St. Clair is in front, and she will win it. But will Rocco McManus be joining her? Let's find out. But the final game of the count, Fremantle versus Adelaide. Fremantle. Z. Everett, 1 vote. Adelaide, H. Carlson, 2 votes. Adelaide Cutsey, 3 votes. And I declare the winner of the 2020 CJ Willing Trophy, Faith St. Clair of the East Sydney Roosters. Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to the Willing Trophy winner. Faith St. Clair was picked pick number 16 for the East Sydney Roosters in the 2015-16 FAFL draft from the QSFL club Northgate. Going through the junior system, Faith was one of the most popular players in her hometown of Rockhampton, where she found a way into the hearts of her family and fans. Faith was notable in this respect, as she was a rodent coming through a city mostly populated by lizards and birds. After being drafted by East Sydney, Faith immediately became a vital part of the Roosters thanks to her meticulous play on the field and her great play, great attitude off of it. While the Roosters were slow with results, Faith was certainly playing like a champion. 2020 has been an up-and-down year for the East Sydney Roosters. The team started the year 0-5 and were 4-7 at the halfway point. The team would beat highly ranked teams 1 week and then lose the lower competition the next. The team would end the season 10th with a 9-13 record. While the team was not playing its best football, Faith St. Clair was. Almost all the time, Faith would be the best player out of both teams on the field, and thanks to that, she is the first player since Kenneth Murphy in 2014 to win the Willing Trophy, while also not playing in one of the teams playing in the grand final this weekend. Congrats to Faith St. Clair, the 2020 CJ Willing Trophy winner. And a look at the final standings, as Faith St. Clair wins the 2020 CJ Willing Trophy with 27 votes. Austin Warner coming close in second with 25 votes. And last year's winner and the 2018 winner, in fact, Raka McManus coming short with 24 votes. Leo Smith having a good season, but being ruled ineligible. He still polled 22 votes, and if he can keep it clean next year, I think he will be a favourite for the trophy next year. A big surprise in fourth, Ashlyn Adler of Darwin, the Jimmy Newman medalist, finished fourth. She is slowly but surely becoming one of the best players for Darwin. And 2021 is honestly going to be a big year for her. The previous winner in 2015 and 2017, Rudy Walker, finished 5th with 18 votes, really slowing down at the end point. Angela Condi was kind of the same there. The 2015 Michael Bendy Bruce medalist finished 6th with 17 votes. Then we have a three-way tie for 7th. Colin Travison, Dale Quinn, and Steve Lambert all on 16 votes. And rounding out the top 10 in tight 10th position, Jay Samuelson and Sky Corday on 15 votes. Samuelson having a great second half of the year. And that, my friends, is the end of the 2020 CJ Willing Trophy count. And I apologize for any technical difficulties with this year's one. God, I was up until 4 a.m. last night just getting this stuff done. So if there was any slips or the cracks and all this and that, it was because of that. But anyway, stay tuned for the FAFL 360 Grand Final Edition on Grand Final Eve. And I'll see you Saturday afternoon for the big clash that everyone's been waiting for, the 2020 FAFL Grand Final between Brisbane and Fremantle. I'll catch you guys then. But so long from the CJ Willing Trophy Camp.